Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alright, good evening everyone.
Good evening, sir.
And now we meet again in the 14th meeting, yeah, I think. In English for specific purposes about family law. In this meeting we will discuss about the family law. Family law and domestic relation. Alright? Any one of you who absent? I think there is no one of you hadir semua insyaallah.
Yes.
Okay. We continue to the material. Scope of discussion: family law first, the second divorce, the third about child custody. Yeah. Family law is hukum
keluarga.
Divorce.
Perceraian.
Child custody.
Hak asuh
anak. Okay. Next. The first one we will discuss about what is a family law? Body of law regulating family relationships including marriage and divorce. The treatment of children and related economic matters. Jadi, hukum keluarga itu adalah hukum yang memuadahi sebuah hukum yang berada di lingkup keluarga yang mencakup tentang pernikahan dan perceraian, ya. This both is related one each other. And next about the treatment of children, the previous about child custody and related economic matters. The first one, source of family law, family law. Basically, the source of family law can be divided into two, namely sources of written law and this sources of unwritten law. Ya, jadi hukum itu sebenarnya dibagi jadi dua, ada yang tertulis, ada yang tidak tertulis. Ya, this is the list of base data or hukum dasar. Ya, this is ada KUH Perdata. This is about the undang-undang yang bisa dijadikan dasar untuk family law. Ya. Second, divorce. Divorce is the end of a marriage and break up of a family because one or both partners decide to leave each other. Ya, jadi perceraian itu adalah berpisahnya dua orang yang awalnya terikat dengan pernikahan, ya, karena satu ataupun dua kedua belah pihak meminta untuk perceraian, ya. Pastinya di sana ada sebab-sebab tertentu, banyak sebab-sebabnya, ya. For Muslims, divorce petition are filed at a religious court, while for non-Muslim they are filed at the district court. That is divorce trial process and take 2 until 5 months. Ya. Sebenarnya semuanya ada hukum-hukumnya tersendiri bagi Muslim dan bagi non-Muslim. Ya, apalagi tentang Muslim. Kalau tentang Muslim, kita biasanya ada hukum didasarkan oleh agama kita. Agama kita mengatur sendiri tentang divorce itself. Ya, ada dari Al-Quran, hadis, ya, sunnah, perkataan para ulama, in other way. Lalu tentang agama-agama lain juga mereka ada tatarannya dari agama mereka masing-masing. We'll continue about child custody. Ya. Jadi get to know the various divisions of child custody according to the law. Ya, jadi hak asuh anak itu sebenarnya banyak dibagi-bagi. Ada misalnya kayak ini. Mother has bad behavior. Ibu itu punya kebiasaan yang buruk. Ya, apakah anak itu harus ikut ke ayahnya atau ke ibunya? Kalau misalnya ibunya buruk dan dilihat ibu itu tidak mempunyai potensi untuk mengurus anak tersebut, tentu anak itu harus diasuh oleh orang lain. Ya, seperti ayahnya, atau kalau misalnya dia memang tidak punya ayah, maka harus diasuh oleh neneknya atau kakeknya. Okay. The mother goes to jail. Ibunya ke penjara. Ya. Bisa aja ibunya melakukan tindakan kriminal misalnya. Ya, jadinya ibu itu dimasukkan ke penjara. Lalu gimana anaknya? Misalnya anaknya punya harus disusui, harus masih di dalam jangka umur 1 sampai 2 tahun. Ya. Ada istilah apa tadi namanya? Feeding scope, apa botol itu, jadi kita ibu itu memberikan ASI lewat botol lalu diberikan kepada anaknya. Tapi ada beberapa kasus di Indonesia anak itu dibawa ke penjara bersama ibunya karena anak itu masih butuh ASI. Ya. This is the divisions, ya. Banyak. Jadi segala sesuatu itu pasti ada pertimbangannya, mana yang baik, mana yang buruk. Tentu harus menguntungkan kedua belah pihak. Okay, yes, right. Do you know any cases about family law in your neighborhood? Ada nggak kalian kira-kira kasus tentang neighborhood di lingkungan keluarga kalian tentang family law? Do you get anyone? Ya. Coba, kalau nggak ada, kita bahas tentang this one. Let's take a look at this case's story below. Yeah, this is about Ipul and his wife. What is that?
Ima.
Okay. Could you please read your first paragraph?
Yes. Ipul is well known as a public figure in his city. He is a wealthy young businessman who is often seen in the news. Deep side, this he is a religious person and always looks simply. He is often seen at the market, mingling with the children who bask at the traditional market. He has a wife named Ima who always looks glamorous and haughty, contrary to her husband. Ima has been caught several times flirting at an expensive club in the middle of the city with the male entertainers at the club.
Alright, the second paragraph. Okay, please.
They both just got married 2 years ago and are now blessed with a child who is starting to turn 1 year old. People must be wondering how Ipul called Mary Ima, who has a personality that is completely opposite to him. In the past, Ima asked to be a beautiful, friendly, careful, and simple person. No wonder Ipul fell in love with her. But after the sacred promise of marriage was pledged, Ima became an arrogant and irresponsible person. She was blinded by her husband's fast wealth.
Okay, last paragraph, please.
Because Ima always makes trouble and Ipul has rapidly abused his wife, finally with a very animal's dedication and on the advice of Jung's closest to him, Ipul sued his wife for divorce. He was very deceptions with his wife's personality, which was very contrary to his former self. Ima was sucked by her husband's dedication. She cried and begged her husband to cancel the divorce suit, considering that they still had a child who was 1 year old and needed breast milk. But Ipul's dedication was animals and continued to court.
Alright, this is a short story about Ipul and his wife, namely
Ima.
Alright. Do you get any difficult vocabulary on this story? Anyone? What vocabulary apa yang mungkin masih asing banget?
Blended.
Yes?
Blended.
Blended? What paragraph?
Two.
Second paragraph, all right. Which one?
Animals.
Animals. Anonymous finally made a very anonymous decision. Ya, akhirnya dengan keputusan yang sangat matang. Ya, decision is keputusan. Ya, finally made a very anonymous decision. Keputusan yang sangat matang. Matangnya bukan tentang makanan, but about things, other things. Ya, ada. Vocabulary is maybe blinded, yeah, tadi kan, blinded is buta, blind, buta, blinded di butakan, yeah. Any others? How about Peggy? Anyone else? Peggy is asking, What is asking? Bigot. Bigot is
Mohon.
Alright. How about arrogant? You know what is mean arrogant? Arrogant. Indonesia, that's like arrogant, sombong, angkuh, that's arrogant. Yeah. Alright. About this story, do you think Ipul decision is the best decision for him? Yeah. Apakah kalian berpikir itu tuh keputusan yang tepat buat Ipul? Do you think it is the best? Or you maybe you have another decision, the best decision, the best solution for him? Anyone giving his apa coba? Sarannya? Okay, yeah, please.
I think Ipul vacation is not right soon, considering that they still have a baby who needs breast milk and love from both parents. It is better for Ipul to give his wife another change, considering he has treated his wife with divorce. If the wife within 6 months still repeats it again, then Ipul has the right to divorce the wife.
Alright, that's the suggestion. Suggestion, what is suggestion? Suggestion is
saran.
Opinion is
pendapat.
Alright. That's the Naila suggestion, memberikan maaf, forgiving him, yeah, giving her another chance, yeah, memberikan dia kesempatan untuk lebih baik, yeah, karena menimbang anaknya masih butuh
milk,
breast milk, yeah, ASI. That's the suggestion. You have any other suggestion for him? For Ipul? Yes, please.
I think the decision was right, because considering that Ipul had advised his wife many times, Ipul had also considered it very careful. For the baby, the mother can provide breast milk by co-feeding.
Yeah, the second suggestion. Ipul sudah matang dengan his decisions, dengan keputusannya, karena menimbang Ipul itu udah berkali-kali loh ngingetin si Ima, ya, berkali-kali mengingatin si Ima. Nah, kenapa harus dimaafkan, kata Ipul? Itu that's the second suggestion. Ya, untuk anaknya bisa aja dikasih dengan cara
cuff feeding.
Yeah, cuff feeding. Karena cuff feeding dengan perkembangan zaman yang ada, cuff feeding juga mulai populer, sudah populer bahkan di kalangan masyarakat. Yeah. Mungkin some people akan berpikir kayak ada cerita di sini. Yeah. They both just get married 3 years ago and are now blessed with a child who is starting to turn 1 year old. People must be wondering. Orang-orang pasti bertanya. How could Ipul marry Ima? Kok bisa dia nikahin Ima? Padahal orangnya angkuh, kata orang-orang. Ya. Who has a personality that is completely opposite, bertolak belakang with the Ipul. Ya. Jadi di sini di paragraf kedua juga diceritakan. Ima used to be in the past, dulu. Yeah. Ima used to be beautiful, friendly, cheerful, and simple person. Ketika kuliah itu, Ima itu orang yang sangat sederhana, sangat ceria, friendly, ramah. Ya, dulu ketika kuliah, ya mereka bertemu di semester ke-3. Ya, mereka bertemu di semester ketiga, lalu dekat-dekat semakin dekat karena Ipul merasa Ima ini adalah orang yang tepat. Akhirnya ketika selesai kuliah, Ima menikahi, dan Ipul menikahi
Ima.
Okay. What do you think about those two suggestions? Mana yang kira-kira paling tepat? Yang pertama kah? Or the second? Second situation. Second situation is better?
Yes, yes.
Do you agree with that? So?
Yes.
Alright. Maybe, ya mungkin beberapa orang bakal berpikir itu buat keputusan terbaik. But some people pasti akan berpikir, apalagi Indonesia yang terkenal dengan tata krama dan budi luhurnya. Orang Indonesia itu orang yang sangat pemaaf. Ya. Mereka pasti bakal berpikir berkali-kali, kesian anaknya di Indonesia segala macam. But bagi orang yang punya mempunyai pendirian yang kuat, pasti mereka bakal memilih keputusan yang kedua. Karena toh Ipul kan sudah mengingatkan berkali-kali, sudah diingatkan, giliran sudah mau dibuat cerai mah dia baru, istrinya baru nangis. Oke, okay. Alright. Now I will give you some questions, yeah. Multiple choice question. What is multiple choice question? Soal pilihan.
Yeah.
Alright. I'll give you one.
Thanks, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
Okay. Anyone who want to answer the first question? Naila, please, the first question.
C. Legal issues related to family and relationships.
Okay. Could you please read the questions?
C. Legal issues related to family and relationships.
Alright. Could you please read the question? Bisa bacain soalnya.
What does family law primarily deal with? C. Legal issues related to family and relationships.
Alright, legal issue, related to relationship. That's a multiple choice. I'll give you some minutes for discussing about the answer. Ya, saya akan ngasih kalian waktu untuk diskusi tentang jawabannya. Silahkan didiskusikan. Alright, time's up. Waktunya habis. We come to second question. You can please, could you please read the question and then answer. What is the best answer? Yes.
Which legal process is used to formally end a marriage under family law? C. Divorce.
Do you other? What about other? Do you have any other answer? Is it correct? Correct? True? True. Alright. Now we next to the second task. The next page. Alright. Could you please read the task? Here.
Which factor is often
considered? The story first. Yeah.
John and Mary Johnson, a married couple for over a decade, have decided to part ways due to irreconcilable differences. They have two children, Sarah, 10 years old, and Michelle, 8 years old. The couple owns a house, and John runs a successful business. Mary has been a stay-at-home parent for the past 5 years. As they navigate the divorce proceedings, various family law matters come into play, including child custody, spousal support, and the division of assets.
Alright, finish. This is a short story about who?
Johnson
divorce. And below the story, there is some question about the story. Could you please answer the first question? Yes, please.
What What is the primary reason for John and Mary's decision to divorce? B. Irreconcilable differences.
Irreconcilable differences. Could you please read the second question?
Who is likely to be eligible for spousal support in this case? C. Only Mary.
Only Mary. Mary. Is it correct?
Yes.
Correct? Maybe that's all about our material today. Yeah, I will recall you about today material. Yeah, today we discuss about family law, hukum keluarga, yeah, scope-nya, jangkauannya, family law. The second about divorce. The third about child custody. Yeah, first family law. What is family law?
Keluarga.
Divorce.
Perceraian.
Third, child custody.
Hak
asuh anak. That's right. Yeah. Jadi everything pasti ada based of the law. Ada hukum-hukum dasar. Kita tidak bisa memutuskan segala sesuatu dengan perasaan. Everything ada landasan hukumnya. Makanya itu dibuatlah perundang-undangan, undang-undang negara, undang-undang agama, undang-undang bermasyarakat. Ya, ada yang tertulis dan tidak tertulis. Ya, contoh undang-undang tertulis apa? Undang-undang tadi, undang-undang dasar, hukum-hukum negara dan lain-lain. Hukum kalau yang tidak tertulis apa? Norma-norma kesopanan. That's termasuk itu adalah hukum yang tidak tertulis. Bagaimana adat kita, bagaimana perilaku kita kepada masyarakat. That's the rules unwritten. Ya, tidak tertulis. Today about family law, the second about what? Divorce, perceraian. Yeah, divorce is ketika ada dua couple mereka memutuskan ataupun salah satu yang memutuskan untuk berpisah yang sebelumnya dalam ikatan pernikahan, tapi karena suatu alasan mereka harus berpisah. Itu adalah divorce, perceraian. The third is child custody, right? About hak asuh anak. Ya, there is some divisions, pembagian-pembagiannya. Ada yang misalnya ibunya masuk penjara, terus di mana anaknya? What's the decision? Nah, berarti ikut the father's. Kalau misalnya ternyata ibunya masuk penjara, ayahnya juga ternyata kriminal, di mana anaknya? Ikut?
Ikut penjara.
Ikut?
Nenek.
Oke. Biasa. Ikut neneknya. Ya, segala satu ada hukum-hukumnya, ada dasar-dasar hukumnya. Alright, maybe that's all for today. Thank you everyone for your attention. Yeah. Do you have any questions? More questions? No? Enough? Alright, maybe that's all for today. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.